Good. Welcome to our second webinar for the Master's Degree Program in Finance at the University of Liechtenstein. First, some general technical information for you. I will do firstly a short presentation about the program, and afterwards you are very welcome to ask your questions. Please do not use the chat button for your questions. Use the Q&A button at the bottom for your questions. Once again, we would like to emphasize that we are very sure that we will start our program in September. Our university will open the 8th of June, and we believe that we will have lectures again on campus when we start in September. However, in worst case, we will just proceed online. But what we want to make sure is that we will start our program next semester. Also, this webinar will be recorded. So after the webinar, this will be available on our website, uni.li. So first, about our program, once again, welcome. I'd like to introduce our directorate, which is Professor Mark Menichetti, who is the academic director, and myself. My name is Patrick Krause, and I'm the executive director. Our program is strongly connected to three chairs. The first chair is by Professor Wenz. It's the chair for tax management and the laws of international and Liechtenstein taxation. Then we have Professor Dr. Hanke, who holds the chair in finance. And finally, once again, Professor Menichetti, who holds the chair in business administration, banking, and financial management. A short overview of my presentation today. First, I will try to explain why our students come to Liechtenstein to study finance here in Liechtenstein. The second important point for you is we will have a detailed look on our actual curriculum. We'll go through some USPs of our master's degree program here in finance, then finally some special topics like internships and exchange semesters. And as I've mentioned in the end, I'm open to answer all your questions. So Liechtenstein is based in the heart of Europe. As you can see, you are very fast in many different neighbor countries. You are can go easily to Stuttgart, Konstanz, or Munich in Germany. Our neighbor country, Austria, you can go to Bregenz, to Innsbruck. On the other hand, we have Basel, Zurich, St. Gallen, Chur in Switzerland, but you can also go quite easily to Milano in Italy. Also from the nature point of view, we have very near the Lake Konstanz, and on the other hand, we have really nice mountains where you can go skiing in winter and, for example, hiking in summer. And in the heart of Europe, our students learn in one of the strongest economic regions in the world, here in Liechtenstein. Vaduz has a stable political environment and a very liberal approach to different entrepreneurial activities. We have strong connections to all major European countries. It's a unique situation. Liechtenstein is a part of the European Economic Area and also tightly connected to Switzerland. Therefore, it is kind of a bridge between the European Union and Switzerland. Liechtenstein is very globalized as well as politically and economically. It's well known for, as I've mentioned before, very entrepreneurial spirit of all our local players, big companies, but also startups. It's highly industrialized. We have many different World market leaders here, like Hilti or ThyssenKrupp, Hilcona, to name only some of them. But most importantly for our program, especially Liechtenstein is a financial hub with very well-known competencies in especially wealth and asset management. And this country is very innovative. It's a forerunner in blockchain technology, fintech, but also in sustainable investing. Because all of these different reasons, this is a perfect environment to study finance, and obviously it offers very promising job opportunities. Our program here in Vaduz is very, very international. Every year we start with a very international talent group. Last autumn we started with 21 different countries in our cohort, not only from the German-speaking countries like Germany, Austria and Switzerland, but also from Bolivia, from Hungary. We have a student from India, Mexico, Russia, Slovenia, from the Netherlands, from Tunisia, United Kingdom, and many more. So this is one of our aims to mix every year a group of students which are not only very talented, but also very international, to give all students the possibility to learn in a very economic environment, but also in an international group of students. Coming to our curriculum, I'd like to start with some general details. Our master's degree program is a 4-semester full-time program. This sums up to 120 ECTS. Our language is completely in English. In our tuition fees here at the university, we separate between students from the EU, the European Economic Area, and Switzerland. For them, the tuition fee is 950 Swiss francs per semester, and for all other students, it is 1,250 Swiss francs per semester. Concerning our lecture days, these are Tuesday, Thursday, Friday. Sometimes it's also Saturday because we have international lecturers, for example, from the US, from the UK, who come for 3 days. So sometimes we have to use a Saturday as well for lectures. And as we have changed our curriculum, I will explain to you in some minutes, in the second semester, Wednesday is also a semester day. At the moment, we are in the process of the accreditation for ASCSB, which we are planning to obtain in next year in 2021. Here you see a very general overview of our curriculum. As you see in the first semester, we try to set the basics. So you learn the fundamentals, and on this basics, then we concentrate in the second semester mostly on risk management and on asset management. And as you see, in the second semester, we have our core electives where you can decide up to your personal interests what you choose to study. In the third semester, then we talk about content like investments, corporate governance and ethics, alternative investments, and many very special topics. And finally, in the fourth and last semester, you will spend nearly the whole semester writing your master thesis. Beside our finance curriculum, the university offers cross electives out of different fields, which are not that much connected to the different programs, but give you opportunity to learn a bit different things like presentation techniques, different skills, and this is not that specialized than the programs. What makes our program very special is that we have been accepted to the CFA Institute University program, but also our curriculum has the content not only of CFA, but also of CAIA and GAAP, the three financial institutions. For all of these institutions, you are able to apply for student scholarships. To go a bit more in detail, you see once again our fall semester curriculum. And in the first semester, as I've mentioned, the lectures are about all the basics you need to know. We set very high priority to academic writing, but also to how to communicate effectively. But of course, you learn the basics of different methods, and you start training how to write a seminar paper here in a seminar in applied finance. This is something very important for us, because besides giving students an education which makes them really compatible for the financial industry, they are in the end able to apply for a PhD program, and therefore we have concentrate very much on academic writing. In the second semester, we have core modules like risk management and financial derivatives, but also we have once again a project in finance where you can choose between training your abilities to write a seminar paper, but also to do a master lab, which is some kind of consultancy of companies here in Liechtenstein, and we do several projects with them. As you can see, a very big part of our second semester are our core electives. I will come to this in a minute. First, I would go on with the curriculum in the third semester. There we really concentrate on detailed topics like ethics, pension finance, corporate finance. And here already in our research greenhouse, you prepare for your master thesis, you develop your topic, and then finally to round up your program in the last semester, you write your master thesis. As I've mentioned, something we've changed in our new curriculum are the core electives. We have, so the second semester is divided in two parts. It is the core electives one in the first part of the semester and the core electives two in the second part of the semester. And there you can choose between many different topics. This is just an example. They might change, but we have here thought about what is interesting for students, and you can decide on your personal interest what is most important or interesting for you. Is it different innovations in finance like cryptocurrencies or data science, or you want to maybe concentrate more on sustainable finance, but we also offer different core electives in the fields of law and tax. Also, the university offers cross electives, which are offered across all programs, and there you have these cross faculty electives, where the university offers courses like, for example, in different humanities, skills like presentation techniques, and all kinds of topics that are not very much connected to the programs. Then you can choose a course from one of our two other economics master's degree programs. We have one on information systems, there you could choose data management, or from entrepreneurship, you could choose opportunity recognition and business models. And then finally, we have our finance related electives. We do the CFA research challenge, where a group of students competes against other teams of other universities in the financial game. We offer our educational journey every year, which I will explain a bit later. And then we have different topics, which are a bit specialized. We offer a master lab, like here in the project in finance, where a group of students works together with a local company in order to develop certain things and to consult them. So in the beginning, I've spoken about why students come to Liechtenstein, why they come to Vaduz. And now then I've explained our program. I've explained what we've increased in our new curriculum. And now finally, we have obviously our program itself has some very, very special USPs. First of all, we focus mainly on risk and asset management, but as well as on international finance. We've developed in our new curriculum our core elective topics, which are a new preparation for not only for your future job positions, but also for your master thesis. Our program is entirely in English. This is also why we every year select a very international group of students. We have here at the university a very small campus, and this means a very personal learning atmosphere. We have a very low professor-student ratio of 1 to 11, so our students know our professors know the names of their students. Our program in finance is the only one worldwide with a university partnership with all three financial professional programs like the CFA, GARP, and CAIA. In our master labs, we collaborate with different companies from the financial industry, which are like management firms, small startups or big banks, but also insurance companies, different fintech companies, or probably the financial markets authority. We do every year, or we offer every year, our educational journey. And there we go to leading financial centers in the world. This is optional, but part of our program. And in the end, all of our students achieve a very attractive employability with very visible career paths, but most and above this, if they want to, they are suitably prepared for a PhD program. We have to support our students different scholarships, like for example, from the LGT Foundation, we have our LGT University Scholarship. So once you might have started our program, one of many questions is whether an exchange semester is possible or an internship semester. The answer to both is yes. And we encourage our students to do so. You see here at the left-hand side our regular curriculum in semester 1, 2, 3, and 4. If students want to go to an exchange semester, we would recommend to do this in the third semester. We support them in their very early planning. We have an international office here at the university to support the students in their process of choosing a university, and then we guide them through the process of selecting the courses, and we are also obviously, of course, available once they are abroad. And when they come back, they simply have to do their master thesis in the fourth semester. So it is possible, and we have many students who do an exchange semester. We have many different partner universities and all students who are interested. We find many different possibilities. And for internships, there we recommend the fourth semester, because in this case you do simply the first three semesters like they are normally planned in our curriculum. Then you go for your internship a semester, and when you come back, you would spend the, your fifth semester writing your master thesis. And in the end, you have some experience, you build up a professional network. So both, our aim is to make this possible for our students if they want to spend an exchange semester or an internship semester. What do our students do after they've graduated? We have many, many companies here in Liechtenstein where they go to different asset and capital management firms. They go to one of the big banks here in Liechtenstein or in Switzerland, or probably some wealth management and insurance companies. But they could also go to a financial advisor or to a family office, to financial departments, or probably non-financial companies. As I've mentioned, we have many market leaders here in Liechtenstein, which are not all in the financial industry. But if you want to do it a bit in a different way, you could join a fintech or a consulting firm, or you join a regulatory authority or a central bank. In the end, 20% of our graduates start their jobs here in Liechtenstein. Another 20% move to Switzerland. And until now, all of our students have had a job by their graduation from our program. You have some examples of companies in Liechtenstein. As I've mentioned, we have also market leaders which are not in the financial industry, like Hilti or Swarovski, Hilcona, ThyssenKrupp, but of course we have many big banks here in Vaduz, which is like, for example, LGT, UPS, the VP Bank, and many other companies, whether it is in the financial sector or in a production area. I've mentioned already our educational journey. We offer this every year in the beginning of the summer semester. This year we have plans to go to New York and Boston, which obviously was not possible due to the special situation this year. But we've been also to Hong Kong, Singapore in 2017 and 19. We've been to New York before, to New York and Chicago in 2013 and 18, but also to Beijing and Shanghai. So we plan and do every year an educational journey for our students. This is optional. They don't have to do it. They obviously have to pay for the costs. We prepare the program. And in this normally 1 week journey, we visit many different partners like banks or financial institutions, but we also try to spend some time with universities, with different partners. Like in New York, we've planned to go to the UN to meet the ambassador of Liechtenstein. And of course, there's also always some free time to enjoy some sightseeing. Beside our educational journeys, we do other excursions, which is every year our portfolio management game with another university. We've been to the Kosminski University in Warsaw, to Beijing. We offer every year the banking game, where we compete, or our students compete in teams against teams of other European universities. So we try to make our program as international as possible wherever we can. Additionally to our program, we have our LGT University Scholarship, where our first semester students can apply, and LGT pays for two students the first two semester fees. We have these partnerships with the three financial institutions, CFA, GARP, and CAIA, where our students can apply for student scholarships. We participate every year in the CFA Research Challenge. We have our Finance Awards. We have a Career Day where we very early in our program bring our students together with the partners, with the companies here in the Liechtenstein area. And we also have some extracurricular activities like after work lectures about different topics. And our students can participate also in different workshops and conferences, which is organized by Liechtenstein House of Finance. So to summarize, Liechtenstein is very special as a country, not only because of its small size and its unique situation between the European Union and Switzerland, but also because of his very special financial situation. It's a very big financial hub, and therefore it's the perfect place for a finance program. And our finance program is very special because it's very, very international, not only because of the topics, but also because of the students who start here every year. Our program is completely in English. We have many applications, and we are fortunately able to select the very best of these applications. So if this program meets with your future plans and you are interested now, we are very much looking forward to your applications. So this is the presentation, and I would like to start with your questions. I've seen there's been already some questions. Let me just open the Q&A box. So the first question is, because of Corona, will the next semester start as planned in September? As I've mentioned in the beginning, we will start for sure our next winter semester in September. The university will open in the beginning of June, and we believe, strongly believe, that we will be back on campus for our lectures. But even if this is not possible, because we all don't know what happens in the next 4 months, we will do our lectures virtual, like we do it since mid of March. So what we can assure you is that we will start our next winter semester next September. Sorry. What are the average classroom size? We do accept a maximum of 35 students every year, and plus maybe three, four, five exchange students. Our classes are normally not bigger than a maximum of 40 students. We select the very best of these many applications, and we try to keep the classes small in order to give the students who start the program here at our university get the best and the best circumstances possible. Does this program have a strict cut-off GPA for admission? Thank you very much for this question. We have different admission criteria. First of all, you need a bachelor's degree, which is comparable to our bachelor here in Bad Dutz. This means you would need to have at least 60 ECTS in economics. You should have written a bachelor thesis in your undergrad program. The second criteria is you need to have an English level of at least B2, preferably C1. And finally, the third criteria is your motivation letter. In this, we expect you to make clear why you want to study finance and why you want to study in Liechtenstein and why you want to study in our program. Concerning the GPA, we do not have a certain cutoff. It should be above average, but we see your applications as a kind of a portfolio. So if you have some disadvantages in one part, you can make this up in other parts. But the better your degree is, the better your English is, and the more convincing your motivation letter is, the higher are your chances to be accepted to our program. The next question is, can a third country student get a family unification visa for a spouse and child while studying in Liechtenstein? This is something we are not really sure what our students, once they've been accepted to the program, they are entitled to receive a visa. How it is with a family, please send me an email and then I can forward this to the relevant person here at the university who will deals with all the visa issues of our students. As you said earlier, in the second semester, there are projects in finance and master lab. Could you please give us some examples, which kind of projects exactly in which kind of companies? Well, yeah, we have small, big banks here in Vaduz. We have small fintech startups. So the companies, the partners can be the whole variety of financial institutions. Mostly it is some partners which are a bit smaller and working on a project, and they work together with a group of students and they try to think about the topic from a different point of view. The partners are very different. This also could be an internal master lab where we think about different topics of finance. Next question is, are there opportunities to study German language alongside the masters? Yes, this is possible. And we would encourage you to do so. Concerning requirements for job positions after your degree here in Liechtenstein, it is very likely that one requirement will be German. If you go to like a bit more away, like Zurich, this is not that much the case. There you might find a job opportunity without speaking German, but here in Liechtenstein, if you're looking for a job besides the program or after the program, it is very likely that you need to have a certain level of German. Next question. Is there any German language class on the campus? Yes, as I've mentioned before, we have, besides all the programs, we have courses in English of different levels, and we have also have courses in German, which you can do beside our finance program in order to learn German beside the program. Is the internship mandatory? No, you don't have to do an internship. If you want to concentrate on the program, this is fine, it's up to you. But if students want to do an internship or if they want to do an exchange semester, we support them where we can, but none of these two is mandatory, but it is possible. Next question, are there any student apartments near campus? Yes, we have some colleagues at the university are supporting our students with finding an apartment. We have a student's dormitory, but we also have some private apartments available. Yes, we support all students. Obviously, in our program, many students are not, many students come from far away, and we have different possibilities to support you in finding an apartment or room. The next question is for a candidate in your esteem program who is looking to take some more time than usual, for example, 5 semesters, what may be the maximum tenure of the program? Mm-hmm. Our minimum is 4 semesters, and the maximum is 10 semesters. So after 5 years, you will need to have your degree, otherwise this will be it, more or less. For non-European students, the application date extended till 31st of May. When does it expect to get admission result? Yes, this is true. We have extended our application deadlines for non-European applicants to the 31st of May, and for all other students from the EU, EEA, and Switzerland until the 31st of July. We try to be very fast for all applications. It's sometimes we have many applications at the same time, but we try to be as fast as possible, especially now when we reach the end of May. We try to make a decision latest until the mid of June for the non-European applications. The next question is, what will the application interview look like? Yes, maybe about the process. I normally review all applications, then we go through it through the applications in the directorate, which is Professor Minichetti and myself. And if we think a student is a good candidate, then I do an interview. This is different from time to time. Sometimes it is to talk about some questions that arise. Sometimes it is to make sure or to clarify a bit more the motivation why students are applying for a program. And also sometimes the application is that excellent that it's more or less a talk where I want to just get to know the students who might start our program. So to summarize, the interview is to get to know the applicants and to talk about different questions that arise in our view of the of the application. So it's very different. You don't have to worry. It is one of the main reasons of the interview is that we want to get to know the students who are starting in a program. The next question is, if accepted into your program, my wife will be accompanying me to Liechtenstein. Could you comment some on the accommodation possibilities, private as well as if those not may be available provided by the university? As I've mentioned before, we have some persons who support our students to find a place to live, whether it is in our student dorm or in a private apartment. It is possible to live here in Liechtenstein, but you could also look for an apartment in Switzerland. In these two cases, you are only allowed to work 35%. What you also could do, you search for an apartment in Austria, which is 30 minutes away for Arlberg, and there the prices are a bit lower and you are allowed to work 100%. And the way from Feldkirch, which is the nearest city in Austria, is 30 minutes by bus. So there are different possibilities. If you have any detailed questions on this, please send me an email and then I can involve the persons who are dealing with accommodation for our students. I scored 6 points in my EIELTS in 2014. I also studied in English language in all my academics and highly fluent in English language because it's official language in Nigeria. Is it okay to get admitted? Firstly, we have several English certificates we accept. You can read them all in our admission guidelines. Some possibilities where you don't need one of these certificates, which by the way, shall not be older than 5 years. So the certificate of 2014, unfortunately, is not enough for us in 2014. Other possibilities, if your native language is English, but we want to have this very clear documented, mostly if your undergrad program was completely in English, we would accept this. Or if you had courses comprising at least 5 ECTS, and your university confirms that the level was at least B2, we would also accept this instead of a certificate. Is there any special format for CV? No. You should make clear what makes you special and why you are, why we should accept you. So we concentrate on the content, not only in your CV, but also in your motivation letter, especially. We want to know what you've done in the past. And so we concentrate more on the content than on the format of the CV. I am 61 years old from Singapore with more than 25 years experience in the physical commodity trading industry, working with international MNCs, SMEs, etc. But I've been away from school for some years. I possess an honors master degree from University of Waterloo and Singapore. In general, the age is not an issue, and we try to have a group of students which is kind of homogene. But if we have an excellent application from someone who is older than our average of maybe 25, this is not a reason to not accept an application. Something different is if your degree, your undergrad degree, is long ago. This might be a problem because, as you know, finance changes. And if you've graduated 10 or 15 or even longer ago, this might be a problem. I could recommend, or would recommend, that you send us your application and then you could go through it. But I think the most challenging point would be if the undergrad program is, I would say, longer than 10 years ago. But if you need more clarification on this, you can also send me an email. Normally, the review of your documentation is part of the application. So we will need an application in order to review your documentation. But if you have certain questions, obviously, you can also ask them before by email. The next question is, if the motivation letter contains more than 2 pages, will it be accepted? Yes, of course. We don't have a minimum nor a maximum of motivation letter pages. But also consider it's not the better, the more. Try to keep in these 2 pages, but if you need 3 pages, this is not a reason to not accept your application. Once again, we prefer content than format. The next question is there any campus daycare, any student rate? I don't really understand the question. Could you maybe ask it in another way? I will go You can please try to ask it in another way so I really don't understand the question. I will proceed with the next question. I remain extremely keen and confident doing my best to succeed in your program, as well as contributing to the enhancement of your esteemed institute and my cohort, but realistically, I need a little more time to acclimatize to the academics. I have been keeping abreast more or less in academics myself, as well as through, I don't see any question on this. Are there any more questions? At the moment, not. Is TOEFL English test of 61 points okay? Well, the TOEFL test is one of the tests we accept. The result has to be at least B2. At the moment, I don't know which number of points is B2, but it should be B2, and it shall not be older than 5 years. There we have another question. As there are many financial institutions operating their business in Liechtenstein, including big banks, so it is possible to make a career as an institutional trader. Yes, all of our students make a career, whether it is in Liechtenstein, in Switzerland, in the European Union, or somewhere else. Where we have to be careful is that if you're not from the European Union, it is a bit of a challenge to get a job after the program. As I've mentioned, once you've been accepted to the program, you are entitled to a visa, but this visa expires after you've graduated. And for the companies here in Liechtenstein and Switzerland, it is a big challenge to make clear why they need someone from outside of the EU, because they have to make clear why they don't find someone in their countries. The next question is there any campus daycare for students' child? We don't have something for this at the university, I believe, but please send me a direct email and then I can clarify this. Is it possible recommended to study finance with an industrial engineer bachelor? My practical experience was in the field of finance as well as thesis. My professional interests clearly are in this segment. Yes, your undergraduate degree has to be comparable to the bachelor's degree here in Vaduz. Most importantly, you need 60 ECTS in economics related courses, and you should have written a bachelor thesis. Can I also modify my application submitted already? I believe you cannot do it by yourself, but you could send an email to myself and then we can amend this. Concerning the accepted score of TOEFL, we have, as I've mentioned, several certificates which we accept, and they have to be at least B2. I'm not sure at the moment what is the number of points in the certificates for B2, but it needs to be written on the certificate B2, and it shall not be older than 5 years. Will there be any job-seeking visa after completing the degree in Liechtenstein? I'm not sure. I do not believe, but you can send me a direct message, and I can. We have persons at the university dealing with these special issues concerning visa, and we can find out. So there are no more questions, I guess, at the moment. If you have questions in the next 5 to 10 minutes, you can still ask them in the webinar. We will keep them, and I could ask them, answer them afterwards. Also, if you have any questions in the next days, weeks, month, you can always write me an email or call me. I do think that you are now very much inspired about our program and our university, because both of them are very special. We have different other webinars in the future. So for the moment, I'd like to thank you all for your interest, for your very good and interesting questions. And once again, I want to make clear that we will for sure start our next semester in September this year. And I'm very much looking forward to your applications. Thank you very much and have a nice day.